I heard my first Springsteen song when I was 8 years old, and right away was hooked. And he had this uncanny ability of telling a story through his music, and in a few short minutes could make us fall in love with the character and associate ourselves with the journey that character was on. And in most cases, it's usually a story about someone up against the odds, overcoming an obstacle, and on that search for whether it was the American dream or just a little piece of little peace of mind in this crazy world. When I was 16 years old, it was 1992, my childhood friend Damien and I went to a concert at the old Richfield Coliseum in Cleveland. And that was the first concert we had gone to, and two 16-year-olds driving out there, both products of Catholic school and Catholic education. But here we were at this concert, meeting friends and guys next to us, asking us to buy us beer. And doing all the crazy rebellious things that that go along with being at a rock concert, but had great seats. And just from that moment on, from when the lights went down to when he came on the stage, the presence that this guy brought with him to the stage was just out of this world. My life changed drastically in July 2009. It was the 4th of July weekend, and I was up at my in-laws' cottage for celebrating the holidays, and had been there many times before, but unfortunately that weekend went diving, and I dove off into the dock a couple hundred feet from the house, and the water level had greatly receded from the heat that summer. Then I dove in head first and smashed my head into the lake bed, and right away knew what had happened. I had broke my neck, and I was laying completely paralyzed and just a couple feet of water, and subsequently ended up drowning. And everything I'd been living for in my life up to that point changed in the blink of an eye. And shortly thereafter, a couple days later, I woke up in the hospital bed, completely paralyzed, unable to move anything, unable to speak, unable to swallow, couldn't eat, just confused, scared, anxious, isolated, depressed, and was told by doctors that for the most part, my life was over. I was never going to be able to have anything that remotely resembled the life I had before. Would spend most of my life in bed, the rest of my days in bed, however long that would be. And really all I could, should worry about is just trying to get as comfortable as possible. That wasn't who I was. And I was always taught growing up to believe in myself, to stay positive, to have strong faith, and just believe in the inner will and the inner drive and the spirit of someone. And I knew if I was going to get through this and achieve any kind of life worth living, the life I wanted to live, I was going to have to call on that inner spirit. I found that strength I needed in my faith, in my family, and in Bruce's music. Some of the times I really look back on now and think that kind of helped sustain me was Damien, as well as some other friends, Kevin and Mike, on several occasions would bring their guitars to the hospital. And when they would just wail away and they would just start jamming Bruce songs for hours, and we'd all try to sing, and I'd try to sing at the top of my lungs, which sounded like just a loud whisper. But it was therapy. In a way, it was almost spiritual therapy to just kind of have that feeling that, okay, I can do this. I can get better. And we'd get to the point where they'd be jamming so loud and I'd be singing that it would cause all the machines to start beeping and all the alarms to go off, and the nurses would come running in and they'd be all concerned, like, oh my, what are you doing?
Still racing out of the trestle, but that blood never burned in their veins. I hear she's got a house up there. She's trying to maintain. Well, she wants to see me. You can tell her that I'm easy to find. Tell her there's a spot out near Hades Bridge, and tell her there's a darkness on the edge of town. There's a darkness on the edge.
So after, you know, several weeks of really just getting my body to stabilize, eventually it was time to start on physical therapy. And it wasn't these intense exercises, but simple things like learning to try to sit up, trying to tolerate your blood pressure drops as you switch positions, getting your body stretched out. But they were exhausting, and every little motion, every kind of just stretch or change in position could greatly affect the body with a spinal cord injury. And I enjoyed working hard, but I loved kind of putting my iPod in my ear and just listening to some Springsteen throughout those workouts. Broke one too many eardrums trying to sing my Bruce music while I was working out. It was great for my lungs as well. The louder I sung, actually, the healthier it was for me. You know, looking back on it, it was, you know, very, very crucial, very critical for that physical therapy. And I think having Springsteen kind of along there to kind of motivate me and cheer me on helped me get more out of my workouts than I otherwise might have gotten. So then came April 17th, 2012, and Bruce was coming to Cleveland as part of his Wrecking Ball concert tour. I had secured 4 tickets for my friend Damien, who is actually now a Catholic priest. My friends Mike and Kevin, you know, the guys that had come to visit me and jam Springsteen by my hospital bed. But for Damien and I, this was almost 20 years later, just a chance to go to another concert together. So that in and of itself was special. And I remember in advance of about a day before the concert, I had just written a letter to Bruce's camp, just telling him about my story, about the fact that I was going to be at this concert. And to tell you the truth, wasn't really hoping for much, but just, again, wanted to somehow let the guy know thank you. And they came, we all got down there for the concert, and it was a blast. It was by far the best Springsteen concert I had seen, bar none. So just after he finished Trapped, he leaned into the mic and he said, "This is for my friend Scott." And I was like, wait a minute, he didn't say that, really? And I remember Damien looked at me, you know, and he looks at me and goes, "Holy shit, that's you. He said, you know, for Scott, that's you." And I'm like, wait a minute, are you serious? And it took a minute to sink in, but clear as day, he had said, "This is for my friend Scott." And the song that he proceeded to play was We Are Alive, really about just those that have been kind of, you know, beat down and have faced some pretty tough stuff, some pretty tough odds, but have found the faith to rise above it, and that faith being rewarded. And to tell you the truth, I couldn't think of a more perfect song to pretty much sum up the journey I'd been on. Well, then we were escorted backstage by someone from Bruce's camp, and I kept telling myself, I can't believe this is happening. Max Weinberg had come out and was talking to us, and you know, just chatting up with Mighty Max in and of itself was a treat. And this guy was just so down to earth. Probably spent about 10 minutes talking to him, and then he walked away, and here comes Bruce walking down the hall, looking every bit the legendary rock star that he was, munching on this giant soft pretzel. And he saw me, made eye contact with me, and he came right up to me. And Bruce leaned right in, kissed me on the head, and said, "God bless you." And then, you know, he noticed a medallion I was wearing around my neck, a certain, Catholic medallion. And it's the exact same one that Bruce can often be seen wearing as well, too. And he looked at it and he leaned in and he goes, "Ah, a good Catholic boy." And I remember looking at him saying, "Yeah, we got to stick together." And he kind of smiled and chuckled and took some pictures together. And I finally had that opportunity to say, thank you, to the man himself, who literally, whose music, in a way, had kind of helped save my life. I think it was a special night for him as well, too. Just the encounter, him having a chance to meet me, just as much as it was for me meeting him. And it's something that'll stay with me forever. I had the opportunity to give him one of the bracelets that I had given him before in the letter. And he took it, and he put it on right away. Getting back up, stand strong with Scott. And, it was just a wonderful, wonderful night. And there's a line from one of his songs, Trapped, that just says, and I know one day I'll walk out of here again. And I know someday that I'll walk out of here again. I don't know when that day will come, but I truly believe that one day I walk again. And when that day comes, it'll be a Springsteen song that'll be playing when I take those steps. No.